I'll be very fast. And my presentation was 100% focused on my experience. Now, Kabarak University. I'll take half a minute to tell you about Kabarak University. We are a private chartered university in Nakuru County of Kenya. We have about 2,200 students. Our ICT department is relatively small, 9 full-time and 2 part-time students. And we have quite a number of functions at the ICT department. They're obvious, I need not mention them. The focus of my presentation really is to tell you what has been my experience in deploying an integrated information system at Kabarak University. And we have made significant strides in this process. In July 2010, before I joined the university, there was a finance system, custom made. The library system was proprietary, Mandarin. A HR system in-house. A website was maintained in-house and kind of stale. We had an email server in-house. The e-learning platform existed, quite dormant. We didn't have any integration. And we got internet. I said not 99% reliable. I'm trying to give KENET some credit here. I don't want to give the percentage, but nothing is 100. That's why I put 99%. The important points are number 9, 10, and 11 that our students used to carry some small handbooks with leaflets for the meals. That's what I found. We had the exams results posted on notice boards and timetables also posted on notice boards. Sounds quite archaic, but that is what I found in 2010. Very archaic. I was shocked. However, the management was wise and they had seen this archaic approach to doing things in the year 2010, and they decided to revamp ICT infrastructure. I mean, they just focused on ICT and they said, this thing must work for us. And the first step they did was to hire me as a full-time ICT manager. Yes. Before then, they did not have a full-time ICT manager. That tells you something about the importance they placed on ICT before that point. They did something called headhunting. In addition to that, they also decided to revamp the infrastructure, and they've been doing quite well. And my specific mandate when I was hired was systems development and integration. My background is systems development, and they were very specific on what they wanted. So now, how did we start? We did a needs analysis, and we determined that what the immediate needs were online registration, computerization of the catering process, and integration of the various systems. We reviewed a number of systems, commercial ones, and we found that first and foremost, we couldn't afford them. Honestly, we couldn't afford those systems. The next thing, they needed significant in-house expertise to customize. We are talking SAP, we are talking Navision, we are talking Oracle, in addition to the costs. I mean, we didn't have the expertise to do this in-house. And of course, they were not exactly suited to our processes. So what did you do? We went back and looked inside and decided, fine, we're going to try to do this thing in-house. So we restructured the department and allocated some members of staff to do full-time systems development and hired an additional developer. So in total, we have 2 in-house developers, including myself, the senior one. And we went the open source direction. Again, costs. And on my part, a matter of preference, based on my experience, that I was more comfortable open source. However, we still had the finance system and the HR and the exam systems done in Visual Basic 6 and SQL Server 2000. So it's not 100% open source. So after this decision, 1 year later, that was by October, at the time I made the presentation, the proposal, is that the cafeteria system had been developed and used by September of that year. The meal cards were gone in about a month. The student portal was developed since then, and in May and October of this year, we managed to give students their results online. We managed to do online registration this August and this September. Baptism by fire. It was an open heart surgery, no anesthesia. The patient was quivering and screaming, but I tell you, we did it. We are now moving on to complete a full cycle, which is produce exam cards, and yes, all the while the patient has not been sedated. It's been quite painful, by the way, but The reason for this is that management were cheering me on and they told me, let's buy the bullet. We did, we are not regretting it. We've integrated our systems. Now the student portal that we developed is able to get a view of finance and admissions in the student portal. Of course, the exam system is totally offline. We only import results into it for security reasons. Now, we have an online application and approval process that is ready and done, but yet to be commissioned. The priorities are not in that direction, but it works. We've also made progress by migrating our email to Google to remove the dependency on an in-house email server, courtesy of internet cuts. Once in a while, email gets lost, so just thought let's go to the cloud on that one. We've procured additional hardware, and we are looking forward to KENET giving us a fiber to main campus. Actually, connectivity has been one of the fires we've been facing, because when there's no internet, the student portal is not available and the whole campus is on fire. We can't register, we can't see our results, we can't get, anybody outside main campus is really crying. The benefits are clear, we've benefited a lot. Less printing. This is one thing I see and I marvel, that we had to order cartons and cartons of paper, and that no longer happens. No more printing of result slips, no more printing of invoices and performer invoices. The students just do themselves if they want the invoice. So you can imagine the significant reduction in printing. The only piece of paper a student gets today is the receipt after paying fees, and that is it when they come. And you can imagine how fast the process has become. Our catering services, they're able to know what's going on, how many meals were consumed. Students are also able to manage their catering fee. The registration process has also improved. There's a better control of the way people take retakes and maximum semester loads. With the paper system, it was possible to sneak in units, yeah, and don't pay for them. Because after all, with a pile of papers, head of departments and deans just sign and get this pile away. But a system doesn't just sign and get the pile going. The registration process is very fast. The only queue is at finance. From that point, they move on to the halls and get their accommodation. It's very easy to enforce their payment, fee payment policy. In other words, this system has been a policy implementation success. There's a policy, you want to enforce it, the system does it for you. It is not biased, it does not listen, it does not understand, it just enforces. Accommodation, it's possible to know the levels of occupancy and again, policy implementation success. Management, they're able to know how many students are in this campus and where are they, what are they doing? When are they dealing with students, they're able to see those results without having to write a note to the exams department, send me so-and-so's results as we discuss their disciplinary issues. Employee productivity. We had clerks hired to key in those course registration forms. They would do 7 days a week before exams. Now, last week, they waited for a CSV, which they imported into the exam system, and voila, the exam cards are ready. Admissions also had to take the time to key in all these registration data. And soon, even new students won't be any data entry, we hope, because they'll have applied online and given us all their details. So all they have to come to do is verify the original documents. Next 12 months, people think big once they see things are happening. The skeptics turn into your biggest problem now. Now that they didn't believe in it, now that it works, can it also do this, can it also do this? Now they want exam cards online, fee statements online, online lecturer evaluation. This is something we're doing right away as we talk. We are going to evaluate our lecturers this semester online. The previous return on lecturer evaluations was 1%. 1% on course evaluation forms, 1%. With this, we are going to catch them. They won't get an exam card until they have evaluated all their courses. Now that translates, in my view, to 100% return. Technology can make things work. Online submission of results, still thinking about it. They even want to vote online. They know it works. That is what biting the bullet can do for you. We've had problems. One, lack of support. But the good thing, we lobbied management for support. They had no choice. Computer illiteracy, you might be surprised that a lot of members of staff are not only computer illiterate, but computer phobic. We had to literally fight with a head of department. I had to fight, not physically, but it was a shouting match. I told them, we are not going to do your work. I mean, they were shaking and trembling. We had to take them to the registrar academics, who told them the same thing. Imagine, it's 2011. Resistance to change. I mean, things have always worked this way. Just leave them as they are. But again, we are trying to educate them. This is 2011. You realize when the systems are different, there's a lot of mismatch. We find this student has this registration number in the finance system, a different number in exams. Now, trying to integrate that was headache. So we are doing data cleanup. Slow uptake of the e-learning, developing them. Lack of cooperation on website content. They tell us, go write something for me. I mean, we are working with those who are willing to set the pace. Hardware was a problem. It took, unfortunately, I wish my VC was here. It took the crashing of a server for them to sign a check to buy a new server. I had warned them months in advance that this will not handle the day we go live, but they dilly-dallied it until the date crashed. So guys, maybe you might have to wait for the server to crash. Don't fear, just warn them in advance, and when it does, you get your server. I got mine. Power problems, Kenya power problem, but we've got power backups. We got issues of a limited reach of our wireless network. We are working on that. And internet, KENET again to the rescue. Yeah, I like quoting you guys. We've been successful because the Vice Chancellor himself is keen on this project. And that gives me a lot of confidence when I face people. The owner of the system, who is a registrar academics, calls me every day, sometimes even over the weekend, asking me about one or two things about this. And I mean, I'm excited about his interest. And he's been the person who says, I want this done. He has had the exposure, so he knows these things work, and I know they work. And the three of us, me, VC, and him, we know it works. And everybody chose the line. Firm and competent. I mean, there is no shortcut to this. I had a systems development background, so I know that it can work. That gives me confidence. I had a specific mandate, integrate the systems and develop what is in there. Ability to marshal support. You must be able to build confidence in the management. They have to have confidence that you can handle this thing. You know, I remember you was asking, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Yes, we face the same problem. People look down on internal capacity, but you must live with it and show them otherwise. And the ability to motivate the staff, especially when they are not remunerated according to their wishes. You motivate them and fight for them. I've been doing that. It's not easy. The developers are competent. That one is there. They are conversant with the technologies. That's not optional. And they take their manager's advice. Hire more, increase, make their terms better. And then, of course, we have to restructure the department. Everybody was a technician before then. Now they have specific mandates. It's not just about systems development. They have to be supported by all the rest. Now, I consider our story to be a success. In that in the space of 1 year, we've moved from a lot of paper and we have eliminated almost 80% of it. That to me is a success. The fact that students are able to check their results online from Mombasa, Nakuru, wherever, that is a success. And soon, they're able to apply without having to physically step into Kabarak University, pay their fees at the bank, and get their letter of offer, that will be a success. It can be replicated. And that's why I'm here today. That's why we are here for this forum. Let's talk and let's see what you can also do in your case. With those few remarks, thank you so much for your attention.